And I'm Jacob, and this is the Wildcat News for Friday, May 17th.
Please make sure you're wearing your IDs.
If you don't have your ID, then please make sure you get a temporary ID from your homeroom teacher.
Please stand for the pledge.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Here are today's announcements.
Let's see the lunch menu for today. Let's learn our Wildcat word of the day.
Yeah.
Why are you recording me?
Stop, why are you hitting yourself?
I'm not
why are you
hitting
myself.
Yourself? Oh, are you filming this for the annoying word?
Why are you hitting yourself?
Charles, your sub
hi,
count is going down.
Hi.
The Pelham Road Dennis celebration for May birthdays will be held during all three lunches. We have a news report created by broadcast journalism students.
Number 10, you get to listen to music. Okay, so this might sound like a very obvious one, which kinda is, but like, so you get to listen to your music before you play it. Instead of just going in blind and playing the music, you get to listen to what it sounds like before you mess up the song.
Number 9, very fun. This one is obvious, that's why it's not higher on the list. But at first glance, it might not seem that fun if you don't know how to play an instrument and you're not interested in it, but it's still better than sitting in your class writing down with paper and pencil.
Number 8. You can't take cellos or basses onto the bus. Reason for this is because they're too big and bulky, and you'd have to require an entire seat just to take them onto the bus.
Number 7, the orchestra class has had a sub almost all year. So for anybody who didn't know, Miss Holden, the normal orchestra teacher, has recently had a baby at the beginning of the year. So she has been on maternity leave since mid-October, and we have had around 5 different subs over the whole school year.
Number 6, strings is an all-year class.
Number 5, there's barely even any paper and pencil work to be done because you can play and there's stuff all the time. There is paper, but you don't have to write on it half the time because it's music sheets. So yeah.
Number 4, any instrument that has strings really is considered a strings instrument. So say guitar, that's a strings instrument. Piano, technically a strings instrument. Violins, yeah, it's a strings instrument.
Number 3, you can't take band and strings at the same time. This one is a lesser known fact, but it's also very self-explanatory, so moving on.
So, number 2, strings won superior trophies for 7th and 8th grade last year. It was actually really cool because it was on the homepage of the Hillcrest website.
And finally, number 1, our most shocking fact, violins.
Do you know anything about strings?
Yeah.
Okay, like what?
Violins.
That's cool. Perfect answer. Yeah.
We have a lot of events going on at HMS next week. Come out to support all of our Wildcat musicians and athletes.
This is a sports trivia question from me. Which MLB team has the most World Series wins? Answer is A.
Hey guys, it's me, Mark Judith, with your daily quote, and I'm here with...
I am Mrs. Banks, 7th grade English teacher.
So what's your quote for today?
My quote for today is from Audrey Hepburn, a famous actress from back in the 40s, 50s, I believe, 1940s and 50s. And it's nothing is impossible. The word itself says, I'm possible.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's all the announcements for today.
Make it a great day or not.
I'm trusting you all!
Wildcat News for May 17th.
I didn't think
so. This is the Wildcat News for Friday, May 15th.
17! What?
And this news...
What the freak?
Wildcat News for May...
What is the word?